Hello and welcome. My name is Shannon Cahill, and today I'm here to share with you one of Surface's 5 core cuts, Freedom. Freedom will give your guests beautiful long layers with effortless volume. We will start out by establishing our length and then building into our interior layers. Before we get into cutting, I would like you to keep in mind of the core cutting system. We're going to be working in our green zone, our black zone, our blue zone, and our red zone. And I also want you to keep in mind of the 3 surface principles. Always cut with your end result in mind. Always cut in the direction you want the hair to move. And lastly, shorter hair pushes long hair away. My model Kayleen here has been prepped with Surface's Trinity Protein Cream. This is to help protect and condition the hair while cutting. Its light whiff of Batsu oil and blend of amaranth protein will only add shine and strength to the blow dry as well. After going in and already pre-establishing our length, I can now go in with my Surface TK2 comb and start sectioning out our haircut with some target parting. The TK2 comb makes that easy for us with the added tooth on the end of the comb. Another fun fact is it also has nano barrier to prevent the bacteria growth. First, we want to establish where our black zone is. We're going to take our comb and place it on top of the head. This is going to help find the highest point of the head for us. Where it starts to level out is where the highest point is going to be. So once you find that, you're going to take your comb and target part from the highest point of the head to the back of the ear. Once we have that done, you want to find where your rear ridge is. And you find that with your comb and your razor. And sitting it parallel against the back of the head. Meeting those points in the back like so. And scooping away. Once we got that black zone parted away, I'm going to go ahead and take all of the hair in the blue zone and part that off. This is going to help keep us more organized during the haircut. So the first sectioning we're going to take for the haircut is going to be at the top of the head and the beginning of the black zone. You don't want to take a sectioning that is any bigger than the razor itself. This is just going to help keep more organized during the haircut and make for a lot more precise haircut itself. And this is where you're going to establish your shortest layer. We're going to go in and give her a little bit more longer layers because she likes it a little more soft and subtle. What you're going to have to do is take the spine of the razor, put it up against the hair, slowly turn it upwards, and then shatter that off. And then you're going to keep on continuing back to the black zone directly behind the previous. See your guy? Take the spine of the razor, roll up, and then shatter off. So we have one for the last section in that middle section there. Bring that up. Your guide, spine of the razor, roll up, and then shatter off. Then we're going to go into our corners of the black zone. And shatter off. And once we're done with that black zone, what we're going to want to do is go in and take a half inch of that black zone and put it into our green zone. This is going to now be our guide for the entire green zone. So our first sectioning on our green zone is going to be directly down the middle. We want to make sure to target part our side ridges out, like so. Once we have that done, we can take our first section, pull that up, and this is where we're going to start installing progressively in the haircut. You want to take the comb, the razor, so that it dips the hair nicely, and then just shatter that to the ends, retaining length. Shattering those ends, creating those progressive layers in your hair. And do notice the side that I am standing behind. You want to make sure that your fingers are always faced into the middle of the head so that you get great directional cutting. Because like one of our principles, you always want to cut in the direction you want that hair to flow and you want that hair to move. So whenever I'm finished with this last cut, what we're gonna do is drop half an inch of what we did just cut in the green zone into our red zone and into our blue zone. This is now gonna be our guide for the remainder of the haircut. Time to do those nice clean partings, because it's really the little things that mean a lot. It's really the little things that mean everything. Part that away. And now we can flip this away and start focusing on the back. And now we're going to start working with our descending hairs. We're going to use our guide from the green zone, take vertical sectioning, bring that out towards you, and you want to really make sure that your knuckles are facing the head. Bring that out, find your guide, and then you want to roll your fingers towards you. And you want to be extra cautious when you're in the red zone, because red means stop or be careful. And that's because that's where the finest amount of hair lives. So you want to be sure not to take off too much. Otherwise, you could create a hole in the haircut. And this is just going to progressively go all around. And we're going to be bringing that out, finding our guide, and then descending down and rolling towards you. So once we're all finished with the rest of the hair, what we're gonna do, get her all prepped for styling, so I'll see you in just a minute to talk a little bit about that. So we just finished up with her haircut, and now we're going to move on to the blow dry. She's all ready to be styled, so today I'm going to choose to use Jump Mousse on Kayleen. This is going to add some really great volume in her crown and overall really great body everywhere else. Then we're going to use a little bit of her bamboo oil. This is going to leave it really soft and give it a great shine. So I'll see you in just a few, and we'll be ready to start some dry detailing. And now to add a little bit of framing through the haircut, what you're gonna wanna do is just take a little bit from the top here, bring that straight up from where the hair lives, and where that hair bends is where you're gonna wanna place that razor. You're gonna take the spine of the razor, flip it upwards, and then just lightly shatter that to the ends. This is going to create a network of hair that pushes the longer hair. And you can already see the great volume that it adds to her haircut. And now she's ready for a night out. And now Kayleen is all ready for a night out. I want to thank you for taking the time to educate yourself on Surface's Freedom Haircut. I hope this gives you the tools you need to execute these new techniques you've learned, and I challenge you to try them on the next guest that sits in your chair. Thank you so much again, and have a wonderful day.